Who are you? And what do you want?
The year was 1972. A pornographic film came out that would cause a sensation. The movie was Deep Throat, starring Linda Lovelace, a newcomer noted for a particular sexual skill.
I'm not turned off to sex.
Darwin Porter, author of the new book Inside Linda Lovelace's Deep Throat, recalls what made the film so unusual for its time.
It had a plot. I mean, not a great plot, but a plot. And it had certain comedy overtones to it, too.
Attempts to ban the film only made it more of a must-see, and Deep Throat went on to earn a reported $600 million. It even inspired the name Bob Woodward gave his secret source during the Watergate investigation.
How much can you tell me about Deep Throat?
Action.
Now, more than 40 years after Deep Throat came out, a new movie tells the story of the film's star, and it's not a happy one.
To me, it's a movie, like any other movie.
Amanda Seyfried plays the lead role in Lovelace.
I did a lot of research, and it's eye-opening. The stuff that she went through, nobody wanted to believe that she was a victim because she was a porn star.
The film presents Lovelace as a passive young woman, coerced into doing porn by her then-husband, Chuck Traynor.
She was just being used, I think, every step of the way.
Larry Flint describes the circumstances around the making of Deep Throat as pathetic. The legendary Hustler publisher wasn't involved in the production, but he says he knew Linda and her husband.
That type of coercion actually took place. She was very much being controlled by Chuck. It wasn't something that she'd wake up every morning and say, I can't wait till I get to work again. You know, that wasn't the situation.
The film Deep Throat.
Traynor died in 2002, just months after Linda suffered fatal injuries in a car crash. In a 1986 interview with CNN, she was asked if she'd done porn of her own free will.
Nobody held a gun to your head, or did they?
Well, that's just it. Someone did hold a gun to my head. I was in constant fear of my life.
Lovelace later remarried and settled down. She repudiated Deep Throat and became an anti-pornography advocate, earning praise from feminists. But her position on porn changed in the last part of her life, says author Darwin Porter.
She started attending porno conventions and started selling Deep Throat memorabilia. So it was almost a turnaround.
Flint says Lovelace's landmark film came along at a key moment when porn flicks were going from Dirty Little Secret to something more mainstream.
You've seen a very budding industry there. It was no longer something that was in the seedy back room of some adult bookstore.
She did launch a billion-dollar industry, and she is the queen of it all, a very unlikely queen. But history sometimes selects very unusual people to put on thrones.
Nichelle Turner, CNN, New York.